Welcome to Under the Lights. I'm Denise Thompson.
And I'm Gino Gradkowski. Another week, another Blue Hen win. It was a hard-fought game. St. Francis put up a good fight, but we played Delaware football, and that's hard to beat. Discipline showed up again in this game in the turnover battle, winning the turnover battle 2-0. And then penalties as well this week. St. Francis had 60 yards of penalties versus Delaware only having 25 yards of penalties, and that makes a big difference in the game.
I mean, absolutely. But, you know, another thing that made a big difference was our student turnout. Holy moly, you know, just talking to Coach Rocco, and he said that was the best turnout for the student population since he's been here in his last 5 years. You know, we had over 13,000 people in the stands. Our Blue Hens were screaming, they were cheering, they were yelling, and they were just standing up and they were active, you know, when it was slower, when it was faster. There was no change of pace. And for you, Gino, to be able to see that and see the students going crazy, you know, what would that have meant for you when you were on the field playing?
That makes a huge difference. It really does. You feel the energy from the crowd. It was great to see that student section packed on Saturday night. And they had a lot to be excited about. We methodically dominated throughout the game, I felt. And if you look at the drives, there's eight drives. Each team had eight drives minus the ninth drive. With St. Francis had 10 seconds at the end of the second half, at the end of the first half, and then we had to kneel down at the end of the fourth half, end of the fourth quarter. But out of those eight drives, we had five scoring drives, including three scoring drives in a row to end the first half, which was huge. We talk about those swing points, the points that you get right at the beginning, right before halftime and right after halftime. We were able to score and get a touchdown right at the end of the half. So five scoring drives out of eight. And then if you look at St. Francis, if you look at our defense, out of their eight drives, we forced them to punt four times, including three and outs. And then we had two turnovers, an interception and a fumble. So I just felt like the way that we played that game throughout the game made it hard for St. Francis to get anything going, build any momentum.
And, you know, I think that was good because really what it was, our game at Maine, our game this past weekend at St. Francis, two completely different games. You know, one, when we were at Maine, we got out fast, we got out hard, and we put those points up. You know, St. Francis was a little slower for us, but people just don't understand, like, it doesn't matter, like, the name on the jersey, right? Every game is different, and that's how it will be. And so speaking of different games, we'll be playing Rutgers this week. You know, which is just so crazy. We have not played them since 1973. And fun fact, ladies and gentlemen, is the Ethernet was invented in 1973. So that just shows you how big of a difference was from everything. And for, you know, Rutgers, they are 2-0 to start the season. They are coming off a win over Syracuse. You know, we are 2-0 as well to start the season. So it will definitely be a battle up in Piscataway, New Jersey come this weekend.
Yeah, it's very exciting. It's going to be a great test for our guys to go against a Big Ten team in a Big Ten environment who's undefeated. It's going to be a great test. It's going to show, you know, what we're all about, what kind of team we are. And I think that we're going to learn a lot from this game and be able to take away a lot from it.
You know, the last time that Delaware won an FBS game was in 2007 over Navy, where we came away with a 59-52 victory. You know, besides that, I mentioned before, we are 2-0 to start the season. That's one CAA game. That is one non-conference game. And, you know, for us, it is, we're ready. You know, the team is ready. That energy is there. And we're ready to compete in any kind of environment, you know, that we will face. So I think that that is just what we have, you know, right now, 1-0 in away games, looking to make it 2-0 this Saturday at Rutgers.
Yep, and disciplined football, the way that we play football, it doesn't really matter who we're going against. So if we're able to play Blue Hen football this Saturday, I think a lot of good things are going to happen. If we play disciplined the way that we have been, limiting our penalties, limiting the turnovers, I think some good things will happen this Saturday.
You know, talking about good things happening, discipline, efficiency, being able to see the field, we have quarterback Nolan Henderson coming up for us next. Stay tuned. We're back for Under the Lights, and Gino and I are joined by junior quarterback Nolan Henderson. So great to have you here with us today.
Thank you for having me.
Nolan, as a Delaware kid, I know you went to a lot of games at Delaware Stadium. How did it feel to be back in front of a packed crowd this weekend?
Felt awesome. Just the energy. You could feel it just running out on that field. You know, we kind of lost a little bit of that in the spring, so to have that in this fall and, you know, have a packed stadium was definitely a cool experience. It definitely gave us some energy.
Talk to us about your off-season preparation a little bit this past season compared to the season before, where it was clearly just a little bit different there.
Yeah, I mean, obviously the quick turnaround kind of changes your approach. You know, sometimes you take some time off, or you know, you have usually a weightlifting session or season, but we didn't really have that. Kind of right back into the next season, kind of prepare, hit the reset button as quick as you can, because the fall season's coming around, and you know, getting your body right. Just, you know, obviously after the season you're a little banged up, so just treating your body right, but having that balance of, you know, getting ready for the next season for sure.
Knowing that you are clearly, you know, working and putting hard on the field, talk about how you and your teammates have been able to bond off the field. And when we talked to Coach Rocco a couple weeks ago, we talked about the Eagles preseason game that you guys went to. And what did something like that was so unique but football related, being able to see alum, you know, Joe Flacco out there, how was that for you guys as Blue Hens?
Well, we just enjoy each other's company.
You know, now?
No matter where we're at. So it was cool. We had a lot of Eagles fans, obviously, on the team, so it was a cool experience. A lot of Cowboys fans too, so it was just cool to, you know, get out of the, you know, out of Newark and kind of go to Philly, watch an NFL game. A lot of my teammates, you know, want to make it to that level. I want to make it to that level, so it was cool to just kind of see, you know, watch as a fan and relax with each other, and it was definitely a cool experience.
Okay.
Nolan, as a former lineman, I love the way that you move in the pocket and keep your eyes downfield. You do a great job of your movement while also still keeping your eyes downfield. How much has your experience over the past 2 years, entering your third year with playing experience, impacted your level of comfort out on the field?
Yeah, I mean, there's no substitute for experience. And I think early in my career, I was leaving the pocket a little earlier, wasn't as comfortable as I am now. And I trust my guys a lot more than I do, or I did before. And that just comes from experience, you know, this past season, you know, practicing every single day with those guys. You got to trust your teammates, and I feel like I'm getting to a point where, you know, I feel comfortable in that pocket and make the little movements that I need to get the ball downfield.
That's great. I'm sure it helps having a lot of guys coming back this year.
Yeah, no doubt.
What are the keys to the game for being able to keep up the offensive pressure for all four quarters?
Really just staying ahead of the sticks, you know, no penalties, got to be good on first down. And, you know, if we get to third down, we got to make it manageable.
Mm-hmm.
Can't get behind the sticks, make it third and long. Because, you know, any defense is a good defense on third and long. It's tough to convert there. And it's just minimize the mistakes, minimize turnovers, penalties. And we don't have to do anything outside of ourselves. Just kind of play a clean game and play our best football for 60 minutes.
And have a lot of students there, of course.
Yeah.
So I know it hurts. You know, I know that it hurts losing Mickey's experience on the offensive line, but talk about how James Prince has stepped in and played over the past 2 weeks. How has that been for you, that adjustment and change at center?
It's definitely, you know, center quarterback is a relationship that is very close. You know, we have a lot of communication. We're kind of the communicators of the offense. So, you know, James has done a great job stepping in, him and Brock coming in. And, you know, continuity at the center is important, but to have those guys that can, you know, plug and play and do well is definitely a great, you know, aspect we have in our team. And I think Mickey's done a great job of helping James and Brock and kind of teaching them, because he has a lot of experience that he can bring to them.
And how nice is it for you to have an All-American anchor the offensive line at left tackle and David Kroll?
Yeah, it's great to know your blind spots is good. You know, it's definitely, you know, brings that comfort, that poise that I feel like I have this year of, you know, being able to sit in the pocket and trust that my guys have my back, and he for sure has my back.
Yeah. You're able to look so pretty because you got some big guys in front of you. Carry.
Exactly, yep.
Well, thank you very much. We are at Rutgers this Saturday, 3:30 p.m. kickoff on the Big Turn Network. We appreciate you, Nolan, for having you here on our show. Gino and I, you know, we have all these different guests, and it's always great to hear different takes, and especially from the quarterback, because we know that everyone does want to hear from you yourself. Don't forget to catch us and watch us on social media. And I did say watch, but I really meant follow us on social media on Twitter at DelawareFB. You can also catch us on Instagram at Delaware Football. And of course, for all things Delaware Athletics, please log on to www.bluehens.com. Thank you. Until next time.